Hello and welcome back. Survival Saturday with Johnny, Tiger,
and Kitten.
Kitten. I kind of said that like it's Johnny and Tiger and Kitten, didn't I? Huh. Well, Tiger is not here. So, anyway. It's November 6, 2021. Kind of late. And we had a pretty good day, didn't we?
A very good day.
Yeah. Relaxing, doing housework. Washing clothes. Thing with being a martial artist is you wash a lot of clothes because you're always sweaty. And nowadays we got to be very conscious of coronavirus and all that stuff. Mm-hmm. YouTube, please do not block this freaking video because I mentioned the name of the virus. I didn't say anything bad. I didn't say anything conspiracy. I just mentioned the virus. Okay. Point of reminder, if you are into jiu-jitsu or any kind of martial art, when you go home, before you hug your cat, before you hug your wife, before you hug your children, jump in the shower, throw your clothes in the hamper, jump in the shower. That's what I do. So, you know, when I come home, I can't even give Kitten a hug. I gotta rush into the shower so I don't pass anything on. Just being responsible. Speaking of being responsible, today, what was that? I was cutting up a honeydew, and I was just talking to Kitten about basic knife etiquette, and Kitten said I should share that with the video. So before we start, I want to share this with you guys. The biggest secret, the biggest tip I can give you guys on how not to cut yourself with a knife. It's all sums down to, what did I say? Respect the knife.
Yeah.
Okay, respect the knife. Just like how you would respect a person. What do I mean by that? Because there are three things that will make you respect your knife. The three things, points to keep in mind. Number one, don't forget your knife. Okay? When you're hanging out with your friend, it's rude to forget them. Your friend get mad. When you are using a knife, it's very rude to forget your knife. Forget where you put it, forget which way it's facing, forget safety, how to hold a knife, how to hand the knife over to another person, where the knife handle is when you put it down on the table. Don't forget your knife. Yeah? You forget your knife get mad, sometimes you get hurt.
Yeah.
Number two. Don't force your knife to do something it doesn't want to. What do I mean by that? Because some people say, well, knives don't have a mind. What do you mean they don't want to? When you're cutting, let's say I'm cutting Kitten's arm.
Uh-huh.
Yeah? If I'm going this way, very smooth, very smooth. I can do this and the knife won't have any problem. But if I'm going like this, pushing the knife into the target, and the knife doesn't want to go that way. I keep pushing, what's going to happen? I lose control. The knife glides off to direction unknown. Knife bend, and it's suddenly crooked. I hurt myself if the knife suddenly flicks this way, right? Just a quick example. Don't force the knife to go where it doesn't want to go. If you're cutting an onion, and the knife suddenly feels it's kind of got stuck. Don't just like push it through. Because when you do that, that's when the onion suddenly roll over, and your knife slip, and you cut off your finger. When you're cutting a piece of steak with a knife, suddenly the knife gets stuck, and you start. That's when you have an accident. Don't do that. Take the knife off the thing. Find another angle and work at it. Right? When you feel the resistance on the knife, it's no good. Okay? Don't force it. Number three, don't force the knife to do what it's not meant to do. The knife is not a screwdriver. Knife is not a crowbar. Knife is not a plier. Knife is not a hammer. Okay? Some knives are marketed that they have a hammer on the butt end. They say you can use the hammer things. Yeah, you can. But does that mean you should? Probably not. Because don't forget, there's a hammer on this end, there's a knife on this end. So when you're hammering things and you lift your arm up, you forget your knife, you stab yourself in the face. Right? You hit something so hard with the hammer end, the knife bounce out of your hand, come right back at your face. Right? Don't force the knife to do what it is not meant to do. So if those thumbs down to you, respect your knife, don't forget it, don't force it. It should be treated with the utmost respect. It can work for you, it can also hurt you. And with that, we are going to get to today's main topic, which is we are going to do knife defense and sensitivity drill with a knife for the first time with Kitten and I on video. We are going to do this from what is commonly called the cross block, meaning the person stabbing with a knife into your towards your belly, your leg. You snap, you cross your arm, keep your hand open, and you snap your arm down. So your goal is to catch the knife hand between your crossed arm. Okay? So this can't go further. Very, very important when you do a cross block like this is you want to make sure your hip is far away from your hand. Because if she's standing upright like she was, okay, watch what happened. Knife coming in, she cross block. The knife still get to her. Right? Now her leg and her belly is all messed up. So when you do this cross block, you want to reach and stick your butt back. I wish I can find a more graceful way to say this, but literally, stick your butt back. Okay? Reach forward with your hand, stick your butt back.
That's almost like sitting down.
Very true. Yeah. And also, watch your leg. Yeah? Now, once you establish the cross block, this is where the real fun begins for today's video. Because just cross-blocking it is not going to save you. Most people will not stab and keep it here. Most people, once you block, they'll pull back and now you're injured. Now you're dead. So once you establish a cross-block, knife coming in, cross-blocking, you want to stay glued to that knife hand. You don't want to lose track of it. All right? So the key is to stay relaxed. Don't waste all your energy trying to hold the person because you won't be able to. Stay relaxed. Keep track of the knife. Again, don't forget where the knife is. If the person pull back, follow them. The person come forward, then you put on pressure. The person try to pull up, yeah, follow them. Person pull to the side, you transition to a baseball bat grip. One hand on the elbow joint, one hand on the wrist joint. This way, they can't lash back at you. Right? If they try to go up, you just lift up. Huh? They try to come back down, you cross your wrist again and stick your butt back. Now we're back to ground zero. Come to your right a little bit so they can actually see this. Okay, I pull back, she follow. I pull up, she follow. I try to twist this way. She established the baseball bat grip. She's very safe. I come back down. She cross block again. I twist to the left. She established her baseball bat grip. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is the finisher. Why is this a finisher? Okay, because from here, I have several options. Okay. One of them, if I am very trained, if I'm very good at what I do, would be throwing the knife into my other hand. This is where she has to react really fast. Because if I throw the knife to the other hand, I come back in, she wants to cross block the other hand. So she wants to let go of this hand and cross block down, because this hand's coming in. Okay? This is a trickier one. We are not going to worry about this one today, because this is more advanced. Back up a little bit. Good. Cross block, knife coming in. Some people said you're stabbing really slow. No one stabbed like that. I know no one stabbed like that. But this is the first time kids can learn this technique.
Yeah.
Yeah. So the goal is not for me to beat her. The goal is to show you guys what you should work on. Once you cross guard, cross block, stay glued to the person. Person pull back, you follow. Person come forward. Make sure the knife doesn't get your hip. Person pull to the side. Baseball bat grip, one hand on the elbow, one hand on the wrist. Person go up, just keep that. Just keep the baseball bat grip. Because they can't come down at you. The person try to move, stay glued to them. Come back down, cross block, good, good. What? Check hip, good. Now the person moved to the other way, okay? So, we already say we are not going to throw it to the other hand because that's more advanced. So, my options are limited. I can either try to swing back, which is not going to work because she's got my arm locked in. I can go up and try to do this, which is not going to work either. I can go back down, but all that's going to do is end up in the cross block again. I know, I already ended up there several times. It's not going to go anywhere. So, from here, most attackers' instinct is to pull right back. So the moment she feels me pulling back, all she has to do is assist my hand and I stab myself in the face. The moment I pull back, I stab myself in the face because all she has to do is push my hand. Okay? And the fight is over.
Yay!
Yeah.
I got him again.
Okay. Let's look at that again. This time, I'm not going to tell her where I'm going to go. This time, she actually have to work for it. Okay. Knife coming in, cross block. I got her. Okay, start again.
Okay. I didn't remember the hip.
Okay. Knife coming in, cross block. I got her.
Okay.
Okay, one more time. Knife coming in, cross block. Good. Okay. Oh, she almost lost it. I got her. Finally.
Okay.
And the only reason I got her is because she tried to tickle me. Eh? Just so you guys know, not a real knife. This is a rubbery. Kind of whippy, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah. I love using this knife to spar with students because you can smack them.
Training.
Yeah. So, anyway, nice little sensitivity drill. When you guys do this at home, you don't even need a training knife, okay? I don't want to hear, oh, I don't have a training knife, I can't do this. Use your finger, okay? Knife coming in, cross guard. Cross block, okay? My thumb is a knife, okay? Very short knife, yeah? So this one is easy for her. fringe game, like some. Oh, almost. I almost got hurt. Wait. Oh. I got her with my thumb. Okay. When you guys work at home, just have fun, you know, and try to help each other build sensitivity. Obviously, you don't want to like jerk it all over the place and be super fast and super hard on it. And that no one learned anything with that. That's stressed out. Okay. Have fun. Take it easy, and then gradually you'll find that the faster your partner starts to move, the faster you're able to follow. But yeah, you've got to learn how to walk before you can run. Just like Kitten. Kitten just learned this today, and she's actually doing really, really good.
Well, thank you.
Now, I will say this. Of course, she and I both totally blind. So if someone just like suddenly walk up to me on the street and suddenly go on like this, I'm not going to cross block shit. Right? Wouldn't even see it coming. I'm dead. Luckily, of my almost 40 years, I've never pissed anyone off bad enough that they want to do that to me. So this technique, that is to say, this cross block technique, mostly, yes, I know, it's useless for us who can't see, because we wouldn't be able to see the knife coming. That's why when I'm stabbing, I see the knife coming, so she knows to react to it. Otherwise, no, if she just stands there, I can get her every time. Yeah. But this world is largely not just blind people. Mm-hmm. Too bad. Might be a better world if it was. But anyway, that's just my opinion. It's a very useful technique. For those of you that can see, please cherish the fact that you can see and this technique works for you, because it doesn't bloody work for us. So that's it, folks. Survival Saturday. We'll be back tomorrow, Soul Search Sunday, with Tiger and Aslan. Have a good night.
Good night.